Chris, what's your thoughts this morning?
This is the sort of event we've been dreading, and not only if you're a Trump supporter, just anybody who follows American politics has seen how toxic and divisive it has become, and we've all dreaded the resurrection, if you like, of political violence in the US. It's been a threat in their history for centuries, of course, and we all really dreaded this. It's shocking to see it unfold this morning. You know, I think Trump is a divisive figure. I'm not as enamored with him as you are, although I think the world was a stronger, safer place when Trump was president than Joe Biden. But as you've been discussing this morning, the Democrats and all the way to the White House, President Joe Biden himself, they've been demonizing Trump day after day after day. And this has consequences. And I just saw the statement there, the live statement that you went to in the US with Joe Biden offering his comments. And I think what's critical here is what Joe Biden did not say. Mm. I thought that was a disgusting statement from the president at such a time of chaos and concern for American democracy. He said nothing to call off the dogs, if you like, off Donald Trump. Nothing to say that we've got to stop being this divisive and not demonize this man. He gave it very, very short shrift, in my view. He should have been absolutely telling people that this is a fair political contest between two political parties who are legitimate and are legitimate contenders. He should have denounced the way that Donald Trump has been demonized by so much of the media and so much of the political debate. But he can't do that because he's been the leading denouncer, if you like. So, look, this is really, really problematic, of course, for the American political system, for the Democrats. And you only had to look at the way that Donald Trump responded, and we're seeing some of those pictures now. Of course, Donald Trump wanted to appear defiant and strong, and good on him for doing that. But let's remember, too, he wanted to signal to his supporters there and to supporters around the country that he was okay, that he was going to walk off the stage. But let's mention those Secret Service agents there, men and women. What they're doing there, and most viewers, I think, would understand this, they are putting themselves between the target and the shooter. They are making sure that if there are subsequent volleys of gunfire, that they will be hit rather than Donald Trump. Now, these Secret Service agents, they'll be registered Democrats, registered Republicans. We don't know their politics, but their job is to protect the candidate, in this case, the former President Donald Trump. And it's just, I think, incredible to see them putting themselves in harm's way to make sure that if there is another shot, it will hit them rather than Donald Trump. Brilliant
Chris,
stuff.
Absolutely, Chris. Have a look here. We're seeing shots outside the hospital where Donald Trump is being treated. It's Butler Memorial Hospital there in Pennsylvania. So they've got shots that are happening. So he's inside there.
Chris, I wanted to, and also there's some talk that Trump may have been hit by glass from the shattering teleprompter. There's some discussion that may have also been what entered his ears. We'll find out more about that soon. But Chris, I want to ask you about, you know, philosophically, there's a bigger issue here. And, you know, we talk about the contest of ideas. And really, to me, that Biden statement seemed to be saying, you know, we could take the contest of ideas out of the realm of, you know, speaking and talking and debating and discussing. It seemed almost to make, you know, an excuse when he said that this kind of violence. And talk about what is happening to politics around the world here when we have this situation where, you know, people are starting to even begin to equivocate on this.
Well, exactly, James. It was just terrible. The other factor of this statement from the president was that he didn't know anything. You're telling me that the president of the U.S. couldn't get a call from someone at the scene to at least let him know whether the fatalities have been the shooter and an innocent victim or not. So he gave people no information. But you're right. His condemnation of violence was nuanced. It was weak, and it was not as strong as it should have been. And he said nothing. nothing to actually defend the right of the other candidate, of Donald Trump, to hold this sort of... He said, I should be able to hold a rally like that. Well, no, it should be more than that. This
exactly.
is a bloke who's a legitimate candidate. He should be able to be contest this debate. He should be able to go about his business without being demonised daily by the media and by Democrats. And we need to respect this as a contest of ideas, not as a... Remember, this is a president who says every day that the very future of democracy is on the line. So he's telling people, unless they defeat Trump or get rid of Trump, the whole of American democracy fails. That is an absolutely divisive and inflammatory line and proposition to put. And he should step back from that, and he should be telling the nation that that is not what's on the line.
Chris Kenny, absolutely. Thanks so much for chatting to us here on Outsiders.